the rock of our salvation, lift up your heart and sing. So easy for me, our God's people, for he has shown us his ways. He gathered us to his table to partake of his ways. Come, let us sing to every nation, great is our God and is the rock of our salvation. Lift up your heart and sing. Great is our God and King.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God
and sisters that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words and what I have failed to do. And I ask the Blessed Virgin
through my fault, through my most grievous fault.
Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, ever-Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who through the folly of the cross wondrously taught Saint Justin the Martyr the surpassing knowledge of Jesus Christ, grant us through his intercession that having rejected deception and error, we may become steadfast in the faith through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the letter of Saint Jude. Beloved, remember the words spoken beforehand by the apostles of our Lord Jesus Christ. Build yourselves up in your most holy faith. Pray in the Holy Spirit. Keep yourselves in the love of God and wait for the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ that leads to eternal life. On those who waver, have mercy. Save others by snatching them out of the fire. On others, have mercy with fear, abhorring even the outer garment stained by the flesh. To the one who is able to keep you from stumbling and to present you unblemished and exultant in the presence of his glory, to the only God, our Savior, through Jesus Christ our Lord, be glory, majesty, power, and authority from ages past, now, and for ages to come. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God.
O God, you are my God whom I seek. For you my flesh pines and my soul thirsts, like the earth parts, lifeless and without water.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God.
Those have I gazed toward you in the sanctuary to see your power and your glory. For your kindness is a greater good than life. My lips shall glorify you.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, my God.
Thus will I bless you while I live. Lifting up my hands, I will call upon your name. As with the riches of a banquet, shall my soul be satisfied. And with exultant lips, my mouth shall praise you.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, my God. Please stand.
Alleluia, 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 Alleluia. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Give thanks to God the Father through Him. Alleluia, 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 Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus and his disciples returned once more to Jerusalem. As he was walking in the temple area, the chief priests, the scribes, and the elders approached him and said to him, "By what authority are you doing these things? Or who gave you this authority to do them?" Jesus said to them, "I shall ask you one question. Answer me, and I will tell you by what authority I do these things. Was John's baptism of heavenly or of human origin? Answer me." They discussed this among themselves and said, "If we say of heavenly origin, he will say, 'Then why did you not believe him?' But shall we say of human origin?" They feared the crowd, for they all thought John really was a prophet. So they said to Jesus in reply, "We do not know." Then Jesus said to them, "Neither shall I tell you by what authority I do these things." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters who are here and who are watching us online. Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. Ngayong araw po, tinatawag natin itong misa na ito na Pilgrim's Mass because we acknowledge those people who are coming over here in Quiapo that came from different provinces in Manila who wanted to pay homage and to pray in front of Jesus Nazareno. Kaya sa mga nagpunta po dito mula sa mga probinsya, taas po yung mga kamay kung meron man po. Yan po. Palakpakan po natin sila. Palakpakan din po natin ang ating mahal na poong Jesus Nazareno. And pakingitian po natin yung ating mga katabi. Pakisabi sa kanila, "Masaya akong nandito ka." Yan. Kahit hindi nyo po kilala. Masaya po tayong nagsasama-sama sa tahanan at dambana ng ating mahal na poong Jesus Nazareno. Looking into the readings of this past week, let me tell you a common theme for the Gospels and the readings. The main theme of God's message for this week is this: God desires for us. God wants to be with us forever. Nais ng Diyos na makasama tayo magpasawalang hanggan. Kaya kung titingnan po natin, nung nakaraang linggo pa lamang, inutusan niya yung mga alagad, baptize all people in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Gusto ng Diyos na tayo ay mabinyagan sa kanyang ngalan, sa ngalan ng pag-ibig, upang tayo ay maging kasama niya magpasawalang hanggan. Kailan po ba natin unang nakakasama talaga ang Diyos? The moment when we were baptized. According to Pope Benedict, the sacrament of baptism makes us fit for eternity. Ginagawa tayong karapat-dapat para sa buhay na walang hanggan. Kumbaga, in the sacrament of baptism, God already has prepared a place for us, a home for us in heaven. Kaya anong dapat nating gawin? Paghandaan, ihanda yung ating mga sarili upang tunay na makamit at mapuntahan yung nais ng Diyos na puntahan natin sa dulo ng ating mga buhay. Kaya ang tanong ko po sa inyo, nais po ba ninyong makasama ang Diyos magpasawalang hanggan? Amen. Kaya kung titingnan po natin yung mga pagbasa sa linggong ito, the first invitation in the first days of the week, prioritize God. Unahin ang Diyos sa anumang bagay sa mundong ito. Be the servant of all. Maging lingkod ng lahat ng tao. Kahapon, we celebrated the visitation of Mary to Elizabeth. Ang imbitasyon, tanggapin yung Panginoon sa ating buhay at ibahagi sa iba upang tayong lahat ay magkatulong-tulungan na maabot yung buhay na walang hanggan. And in our first reading today, while we are here on earth, while we are here waiting for the end of our life, may sinasabi si St. Jude na dapat nating mga gawin. Pray in the Holy Spirit. Keep yourselves in the love of God. Manatili sa pagmamahal sa Diyos. At yung isa, save others by snatching them out of fire. Iligtas ang ibang mga tao sa apoy. Sa papaanong paraan natin gagawin iyon? Ito po napakahalagang matandaan natin. Mahalagang tayo ay nananalangin sa Espiritu Santo. Mahalagang nananatili tayo sa pagmamahal ng Diyos. At pagkatapos nun, napakahalaga rin na tayo ay may ginagawa para maligtas yung iba, madala natin sa pagmamahal ng Diyos, madala natin at maturuan nating manalangin sa pamamagitan ng Espiritu Santo. Kaya ang imbitasyon talaga sa atin, kapag may nakikita tayong kamalian sa ating mga kapwa, itama po natin para sa kanilang kaligtasan. We save them by snatching them out of the fire. How? By correcting those who are in error. Magtama sa mga nagkakamali. Meron po akong isang experience, isa kong pong kaibigan. Nakita ko po na nangloloko po siya ng tao. Dalawa po yung kanyang minamahal. Dahil hindi po ako mapakali, hindi kaya ng konsensya ko na alam ko ito. Tapos wala akong sasabihin. Ang ginawa ko po sa kaibigan kong iyon, pinagsabihan ko po siya. Sabi ko sa kanya, bilang pagmamahal ko sa iyo, bilang kapatid, bilang kaibigan, I have to tell you this. What you're doing is not right. After nung pag-uusap po namin, nagpasalamat siya sa akin. At sa loob ng isang taon, hindi niya po ako kinausap. Nasaktan po ako, pero yun po yung tawag, yun po yung sinisigaw ng aking konsensya. After a year, he came back. He talked to me, and he thanked me again. Nagsorry din siya sa kanyang pagkukulang at pagkakamali. Nagpapasalamat siya dahil nagsalita ako sa kanya. Hindi man niya na-realize right there and there, but eventually, he realized the wrong that he was doing. Kaya mga minamahal kong mga kapatid, minsan sa pagtatama sa ating mga kapatid, mahirap po talaga. Minsan, sasabihin pa nila, sino ka para sabihin sa akin iyan? Anong karapatan mo? Pero mga minamahal kong mga kapatid, ito po yung tawag ng Diyos sa atin. Ito yung tawag ng pagmamahal ng Diyos para gawin natin itong mga pagtatama. Dahil ang Diyos, dahil tayo ay minamahal niya, tinatama niya rin yung ating mga pagkakamali. Hindi niya tayo hahayaan na magpatuloy sa ating mga ginagawang pagkakamali. Tinatama niya tayo at nilalagay sa tamang landas. Kaya napakahalaga rin, ito rin po yung tanong ng mga eskriba, the Pharisees, the chief priests to Jesus. Ang tanong po nila, by what authority are you doing these things? Sa Tagalog, parang sinasabi nila kay Jesus sa kanyang pagtuturo, sa pagpapahayag ng mabuting balita. Sinasabi nila sa kanya, anong karapatan mo para sabihin ang mga ito sa amin? Bakit sila nahihirapan na pakinggan at sundan si Jesus? Dahil hindi sila handa sa paghahari ng mabuting balita na galing kay Jesus sa kanilang mga buhay. Sino yung gusto nilang pakinggan? Sino yung gusto nilang may karapatan lamang sa buhay nila? Sila lamang. Sabi nila kay Jesus, huwag mo na kaming pakilaman, galing ba saan yung mga sinasabi mo? At ganun din po yung pagkakamali ng ating mundo sa ngayon. Inanais natin na tayo yung may karapatan lang sa ating buhay. Buhay ko to, ako magdedesisyon, huwag na kayong makialam sa atin. Pero tandaan po natin, yung buhay natin ay galing sa Diyos. Kung sino man ang may pinakamay karapatan sa buhay natin, ito ay ang Diyos. At nawa, hayaan natin na ang Diyos gabayan tayo sa bawat araw ng ating mga buhay. Upang tunay na hindi tayo mapunta sa apoy, bagkus ay tayo ay makatanggap ng napakagandang biyaya ng buhay na walang hanggan na gustong ibigay ng Diyos sa bawat isa sa atin. Mga minamahal kong mga kapatid, kapag nagsasalita ang Diyos sa pamamagitan ng mabuting balita, pakinggan, tanggapin at sundin natin ito. Huwag po nating isantabi at harangan ang paggagabay ng Diyos sa ating mga buhay dahil hindi po natin makakamit ang mga biyayang nais niya kapag tayo ay malayo sa ating Panginoon, malayo sa pakikinig sa ating Diyos, malayo sa pagbibigay ng gabay ng ating Panginoon. Kaya patuloy po tayong lumapit dito, lumapit at humarap sa Diyos upang tunay nating makita ang paggagabay niya sa ating mga buhay. At kapag meron tayong struggle sa pagsunod sa Diyos, humingi tayo ng lakas sa Diyos. Kasi totoo naman po na kapag may nakasanayan na tayong mali, ay mahirap talaga yung daan sa pagbabago. Kaya patuloy nating kailangang hingin ang tulong at lakas ng Diyos para mapagtagumpayan natin yung ating mga pinagdadaanan, mapagtagumpayan yung ating mga kasalanan upang tunay nating makamit ang buhay na walang hanggan. At huli pong kwento, ito po ay kinuwento ko rin kahapon. Kwento rin po ito ng naghanap at nakatagpo ng pag-asa sa Jesus Nazareno. Meron po akong tita at tito na nung hindi pa po sila, nagsisimula pa lang silang magkakilanlan, ay nag-decide po sila na magkita sa Quiapo. Hindi pa po uso ang cellphone noon. Kaya yung pagkakamali po nila, nagkasundo po silang magkita sa Quiapo. Pero hindi nila sinabi sa isa't isa kung saan banda sa Quiapo. Kaya ang tagal-tagal nilang naghahantay kung saan, hanggang sa parang nawawala na sila ng pag-asa. Nung nawawala na sila ng pag-asa, nag-decide sila pareho, pumasok sa loob ng simbahan, magdasal sa poong Jesus Nazareno. At pagkatapos po noon, natagpuan nila ang isa't isa. Ang ganda po ng kwento. Kasi kung titingnan po natin, yung kanilang pagkilos, panahon na parang nawawala na ng pag-asa, pumunta sa dambana sa tahanan ng poong Jesus Nazareno.
At matapos nilang magdasal, humingi ng lakas at pag-asa sa Poong Hesus Nazareno, ginabayan sila ng Nazareno para matagpuan nila ang hinahanap nila. Mga minamahal kong mga kapatid, matatagpuan lamang po natin ang hinahanap na kalayaan, kaligayahan at kaligtasan ng ating puso kapag tayo ay patuloy na papasok sa kanyang tahanan, makikinig sa kanyang salita at susunod sa kanyang mga utos. Kaya mga minamahal kong mga kapatid, kung naghahanap po kayo ng asawa, pwede po kayong magdasal sa Poong Hesus Nazareno. Kapag nawawalan kayo ng pag-asa, lumapit kayo sa Poong Hesus Nazareno at hayaan niyo siya na kayo ay gabayan patungo sa mas maganda at mabuting buhay, patungo sa ating kaligtasan. Amen.
Please all stand.
Through the gospel, Christ speaks to us with words of eternal authority and deed of healing power. Through him, let us pray with confidence. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church may continue to teach Christ's eternal truth with authority. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the hearts of world leaders may not be hardened as they hear Christ's voice today. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those considering the religious life may seek to follow the will of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our blameless and holy lives may cast away the unclean spirits at work in our society. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the faithful departed may enjoy the radiant dawn of eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In silence, let us pray and lift to our Lord our personal intentions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, all-powerful, we place before you our needs and pray confidently for your help and mercy. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his church.
Grant us, we pray, O Lord, that we may celebrate worthily these mysteries which Saint Justin strenuously defended. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for the blood of your blessed martyr, Justin, poured out like Christ to glorify your name, shows forth your marvelous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear you witness, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty, without end, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver in evil. Amen.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Para sa lahat ng tatanggap ng banal na komunyon, sasagot po tayo ng amen. Pagkasabi ng pari o ng lay minister ng katawan ni Kristo at isubo agad sa bibig bago umalis sa harapan ng pari o lay minister. Sumunod po tayo.
Stay with me, Lord, that I may never forget you. Stay with me, Lord, because I'm weak. Stay with me, Lord, for you. If you wish me to be faithful to you. Oh, how I need you, my Jesus, in this night of exile. Stay with me, my Jesus, in the breaking of the bread, the light which disperses all darkness, the force that sustains me, that you need, joy of my heart. Oh, how I need you, my Jesus, in this night of exile. Stay with me, my Jesus, in the breaking of the bread, the light which disperses all darkness, the force that sustains me, that you need, joy of my
heart. Announcement. Mabibili pa rin po ang ating official na imahe ni Jesus Nazareno. Ang mga ito po ay mabibili lamang sa ating Paris Finance Office. Ang malilikom po na pondo ay gagamitin sa pagsasaayos ng ating Adoration Chapel at Baptistry. Pinaalalahanan ang mga bumili ng Nazareno medalyon na iwasan itong hagkan o dilaan, sapagat maaari itong magdulot ng sakit. Mag-iba yung ingat at ilayo ito sa mga bata upang makaiwas sa maling paggamit nito. Pagkatapos ng misa, wiwisikan po ang lahat ng banal na tubig. Pinakikiusapan ang lahat na manatili lamang muna sa inyong mga lugar. Tanging sa Quezon Boulevard o sa Plaza San Juan lamang ang labasan ng lahat. Sumunod po tayo. Maraming salamat po sa inyong pagdalaw at pagsisimba sa Basilica Minor at Pambansang Dambana ni Jesus Nazareno. Magsitayo po ang lahat.
Let us pray. Refreshed by heavenly food, we humbly implore you, O Lord, that attentive to the teaching of St. Justin the Martyr, we may abide at all times in thanksgiving for the gifts we have received through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, ang patuloy pong paalala sa atin ng ating Panginoon, He desires for us. He wants to be with us forever. And the path to forever is to always pray in the Holy Spirit, to keep yourself in the love of God. And by doing so, let us also help one another to be away from the fire of the evil one that wants to destroy our lives. Mga minamahal kong mga kapatid, patuloy po tayong manatili sa Diyos at tulungan ng iba na matagpuan at manatili rin sa ating Panginoong Jesus Nazareno. At gagamitin ko rin po itong pagkakataon na ito na magpaalam po at magpasalamat because this will be my last 9 a.m. Mass as a parochial vicar of the Quiapo Church. Ang usual na daily at Saturday Masses ko po ay 9 a.m. At yung iba po dito at sa online po ay madalas ko ring nakakasama sa 9 a.m. Mass. At gagamitin ko nga pong pagkakataon ito
upang magpaalam at magpasalamat. Magpaalam po dahil binigyan na po ako ng bagong assignment. Mula po dito sa Quiapo, ako ay ililipat sa Immaculate Conception sa Tayuman po. At nagpapasalamat po ako dahil sa unang mga buwan ko bilang pari, kayo po ay ang mga nakasama ko. Nagpapasalamat po ako sa Jesus Nazareno dahil dinala niya ako sa kanyang dambana kung saan mas natuto po akong magbigay ng aking sarili, ng aking lahat-lahat. Sa dami po ng trabaho dito sa Quiapo, talagang ibibigay dapat ang lahat-lahat para sa pagmamahal sa Diyos at pagmamahal sa kanyang bayan. Maraming salamat po muli at mamimiss ko po kayo. Patuloy niyo po akong ipagdasal at patuloy po kayong kasama sa aking mga panalangin. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Blessed are you, O God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. You have given us your only Son to be our way to you. Make us follow him generously, faithfully, and lovingly. Merciful Jesus of Nazareth, you have revealed God's grace and unconditional love for us at the cross. You set your church in this world, from which the true light would shine for all to see. Grant that we who enter this holy shrine may walk in your ways as disciples of justice, peace, and mercy and hope. We offer you our prayers for the sick, the oppressed, the youth, and those in need most of your mercy. Hear our humble petitions. Bless these religious articles that we may be fervent in prayer and charity. As we continue our journey as your pilgrim people here on earth, may we set our hearts on the road to heaven, our true home and reward, where you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Padre Jesus Nazareno, sinasamba ka namin, inipintuho ka namin, para mo ang aming buhay at kaligtasan. Padre Jesus Nazareno, iligtas mo kami sa kasalanan. Ang krus mong pinamatayan ay sagisag ng aming kaligtasan. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, arangal ang kami. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, iluwalhan ka lang. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, inarangal ka. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, iluwalhati ka lang.